going to do now? Let's go. Let's beat his ass.
That motherfucking piece of shit.
Definitely my choice.
God, you think you know a person. Bigby, you have to tell her.
I know.
What's going on? What did you find up there?
Crane's the killer.
What? Ichabod Crane? How do you know?
Shit!
Crane's been... Whoa, Bigby, calm down. Everything's going to be fine, okay? It's going to be fine.
Will someone please explain this to me?
Perverted little fucker might be after Snow. I need to find her right now.
Okay, it's going to be okay. Where did you see her last? Did she say where she was going?
She took Holly to the business office to prepare for the funeral.
Lily's funeral?
Yeah.
How do you know?
I was just at the Trip Trap, and I heard Gren telling some folks about a funeral at the Buckingham Bridge.
Trip Trap? Are you drinking?
When?
Right now. They were on their way out.
Oh, you've been chilling with the squad.
Wait.
What?
Snow's been through a lot. There are things she doesn't talk about. Just please be careful when you tell her. And you should tell her. But...
What are you trying to say?
You know how you felt when you saw that picture? Well, it's going to be much worse for her. Just remember that.
Yeah, you might be next. Oh, promising leads. Alright, so this is the part where I cannot interrupt Snow talking and then just basically go to the table and just look at the cards. Oh shit.
I'm honored.
Alright, there we go. She starts talking.
It's tradition that everyone speak. Lily had many friends, but few fables she was truly close to. If you're here, then you were part of a very special circle. People she trusted and cared for. I won't offend you by claiming one day that,
so there's a choice.
That the pain of losing Lily will ever subside.
Just leave her alone.
I know as well as you that it will never subside. But I also know that the memory of Lily will sustain as well. And it will, in time, equal in strength.
I'll miss
to our
worrying about
loss.
You. I'll miss our
and
fights.
And it is in that spirit that
I'll
I'd like to
you.
Talk about what
Holly.
You've all been so grateful to share with me. Your memories of her. How she could be
now you
stubborn
will never die
and
from
patient,
indifference.
Rash
lead a
and
tedious
thoughtful.
Life.
How she carried a torch
sweetheart.
For the old ways.
Thanks for everything.
Tradition for
Vivian.
Pageantry. And most of all, it seems how Lily loved. Dearly
you were a big, bright, shining
family.
Star in
she
this shithole of a town.
In good times
I miss you already.
I never Ren. Met Lily, but from what I've been told, I know in my heart that she would have liked to be here tonight. And now we'll have our moment of silence. Thank you.
All right, she done. Yeah, still leave her alone.
Bigby, is everything okay?
Okay.
No, not you.
Holly, it's...
He wasn't fucking invited.
Holly, wait.
He has no right to be here. Not after what he did.
My bad.
Holly, I'm sorry, but I had to come.
You throw my sister down the witching well,
I gotta get a fable book,
man. You have the
man.
Nerve to show your face here after you lie... After you promise me?
Holly, wait. That was Crane. Just Crane. He disposed of Lily's body before Bigby could do anything about it. I'm telling you the truth.
Don't cover for him.
But this genuinely wasn't his fault.
You can't tell me Bigby gives a shit about this.
Crane's a fucking prick, so this doesn't surprise me.
Ear.
Hey, what do you know? We actually agree on something.
Bigby cares, Holly. He's trying to help, and I'm sure he has a very good reason for being here. But this one isn't on him.
Why are you here anyway? And don't say it's because you care about this.
Everything okay?
I think I know who murdered your sister.
Who?
Maybe we should talk about this somewhere else.
What? No, I deserve to know.
I know, but this isn't the way
to
go about this.
I don't give a fuck about the way.
I think it was Ichabod Crane.
What?
Crane.
Okay, everyone, just stop. Bigby and I are going to have a little chat while everyone else gets back to the funeral.
What? He says that fucking Crane murdered Lily and you expect me to-
Please, I promise I will tell you what the hell is going on just as soon as I know there's something to tell, but just let us do our jobs first. Look, Holly, I know how this must-
No, you don't know how this must feel. You have no idea. Don't fuck anything up. Don't bother anybody. And when the first sign of trouble comes, and it will come because you're a goddamn walking trap for it, I want you the fuck out of here. You hear me?
Of course. I won't even know I'm here.
Let's just continue, okay?
This is such total fucking bullshit.
Let's go, Holly. It's your turn to talk.
Crane.
Yeah.
I can't believe this. This is someone I've worked with for decades. This is a guy... He gets frickin' shakes when he has to order food. I mean, what are you telling me? It's all an act? Just, what have you found? Bigby? What's going on?
Lily was Crane's prostitute. I followed a lead to this shithole motel, the Open Arms. Crane had a room there, and he's been taking prostitutes, or at the very least Lily, and making her look like you while he was, you know.
That's
disgusting.
I don't even know what to say right now. I really don't. I'm just trying everything I can right now to not picture it.
I'm sorry, Snow. And I'm sorry I had
he
to be
got
one
feelings
to tell
for you,
you,
bro.
You're sure this is what happened? This is what he's been doing? Because please, Bigby, don't confuse things. Deposing Crane would be
yeah,
the next step.
Let's do it. By the show. I'm like, yeah, you wanna see? Look. I'm about to scar you for life.
You took a cab here, right?
Yeah.
I'll drive.
Snow?
Narissa? What is it?
I'm sorry, but Holly's asking for you.
Are they starting the burn?
Yes. Everyone who spoke should really be present for this part. She's kind of distraught. You're not leaving yet, are you?
2 minutes. I don't mean to be,
No, I understand.
No, I get it. Take your time.
It won't take long.
How'd it go? At the motel? Did you find anything? No?
Yeah. Lily was killed there. It was an awful mess.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
Narissa!
Yeah, coming!
I feel like that's what happened. Wish she could be on her period then. It could happen.
Constable?
Oh my
gosh. Wait, easy now, girl. You know how this goes. The first thing in a visit, you say, how do you do?
What are you doing here?
That is the question, isn't it? Or at least a question. We'll snip to the chase for all sakes. A little bird told us that you're fitting to go after Crane. And you see, we have an interest in that particular boy. So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone. Just take a little vacation is all.
Are you working for Crane? Did he send you?
No, see now, you're already asking too many questions. Just pay attention.
Man, I just say fuck off.
So what's it gonna be? We have a deal? You leave Crane alone and we leave you to yours? brother.
Sure. Yeah, fine. I'll leave Crane alone. Just get out of here.
Pleasure to hear it.
Ladies, gentlemen, invertebrates, please, rest easy. This is not...
What the hell is going on?
What's happening?
Very sorry to impose, but we only had a deal to work out with Bigby. And we're happy to report that everything went smoothly. So if you'll just allow us to get out of your hair...
Bigby, what is he talking about?
Never you mind that. It ain't any of your...
What deal? I said all right already. Just go.
And go we shall as men of our word. We won't ruin any more of the wedding or whatever.
Get the fuck out of here. Just pissed her off, bro. She don't got time for this.
What did I say?
Ollie?
Think you motherfuckers could come here uninvited? You think you can just fucking interrupt Lily's funeral?
Calm down, darling. It was just a simple business transaction.
You fucking freaks are not getting away with this.
Calm down, Holly.
Yeah, let's spare all the fuss. It's just a dead hole.
I'm gonna kill you!
Holly!
Holly!
I got it, damn!
Shoulder. Oh, she's not dead, is she? Belly full of stones. The Wolf Among Us. Playing that wolf. Wolf Among Us, huh? It's like watching Netflix, huh? Episode 3, A Crooked Mile.
I did as well as I could to take out the buckshot, but there's still some shards left embedded in your shoulder. They'll eventually worm their way out on their own, but until they do, you're gonna be sore.
Bigby, Dr. Swinehart was appointed Fabletown physician for a reason.
It's okay. There's only one thing you have to take away from all this. Take it easy. Don't go looking for any more fights.
All right, Wolverine.
Keep strain off your heart.
I can't take it easy. I have to find Crane.
Bigby? What's wrong?
Lack of sleep for one thing. Getting shot for another. He'll be fine. I had everyone that got wounded sent home. Holly refused to let me see where she lived. So I left her and Grendel back at her bar with a dose of juniper and spring water. Just remember what I said. The stitches won't hold up if you continue to act like you normally do. Everything in moderation.
I'll try to.
All right then. Very good.
Business office. I know, I'll have to call you back. The town is starting to find out.
Well, I'll leave you two to it then. Miss White, Bigby.
So, to recap...
Crane watched me through the magic mirror uncover his room at the Open Arms, and then he smashed it so we couldn't use it ourselves to go after her. And we know this because Bufkin was drinking in the rafters. That about cover it?
And once he puts all the pieces back together, it'll be easy to catch Crane. So, I guess that's the plan, currently. But I don't know.
There's no other leads. This is it. Just wait for the mirror.
Yeah. What the hell is going on? I don't know what the Tweedles get out of this
I don't know if Crane sent them. I don't know if... I mean, this is gonna sound crazy, but do you really think Crane did it? Everything points to him. I get it, but do you really think he killed those women? Because it's just...
From what I saw at the Open Arms, everything points to Crane murdering Lily. What isn't adding up for me is Faith. Why would he kill her? It doesn't seem connected.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense. He was a conniver, a coward, a liar. And I'll always hate him for that. And I'll hate him for how he held me in his thoughts. But murdering prostitutes?
Ow!
Everything okay over there?
Yes, Miss White. Just cut myself on a piece of the glass. Nothing to worry about.
Thanks for tonight, by the way. That could have gone really terribly.
Anytime.
Can I, ask you a question? It's kind of personal. And I don't want to offend you.
Sure.
It's just... When stuff hits the fan, like it did tonight, it feels like before we came to the city. It feels kind of like home. And I've heard it said that maybe in some tiny little bottled-up way, deep inside, you kind of enjoy it when things go wrong.
Oh, no. Fuck
because
that.
It gives you an excuse to just, you know, stop pretending.
So what if I do? You think we're broken or something? Is that it?
I don't know. Maybe we're just not cut out for this world. We can't eat each other's hearts anymore, Bigby. This can't be like the old days. We have to make it better.
Guys? We have a problem.
What is it?
I can't finish the mirror. It's missing a piece.
What do you mean, missing a piece?
Yes, it's not here.
Maybe. Crane must have taken a shard with him.
Oh, I can't believe this.
I saw Crane pick something up after he smashed it. I'm sorry, I didn't realize what it was until now.
Well, the mirror can't work unless it's whole.
Well, that's not entirely true.
Or what, Bufkin? What? We sit around and wait until it mends itself? We have no idea how long that will take. We're just gonna have to do this the hard way.
I'm just saying, waiting is an option.
What exactly is the hard way?
We'll look through his things, his desk, everything.
Okay.
He had to have left something that tells us where he's going. He's a neat freak, but he was never that smart.
Smart enough to take a piece of the mirror. We can still solve this ourselves. I know
never
that
never mind that. Come help me look. What is it?
It's the key to his room at the Open Arms.
Oh, wow.
You still haven't told me what was in there. I want to know.
Crane was, paying Lily to live out a fantasy of him and you together. Forgive me if I spare you the details.
You always want to know. I'm fucking telling you.
I keep replaying moments in my head.
Oh,
interactions with him
that
catch
PTSD
me in the elevator,
shit, bro.
Bump into me outside. There's only so much you can repress, you know?
Don't worry, Snow. We'll get him.
Come on, let's keep looking.
There's a page here that was torn out.
Oh, yeah? Bufkin, do you know what was here?
It's a ring, at least. Every magical item not retained in the armory is assigned to someone in Fable Town. It must be this witch he is going to see.
Wait, what? What witch? What meeting?
He called up somebody. He said he needed to see his witch, or that he would need to get to the witch for that. Whoever that is. Well, yes, it sounded like the one he got his, glamours from.
Oh.
I'm sure it's about this ring. They must have it.
Why not mention this before?
No one asked me.
Bufkin!
And I'm hungover. I'm sorry. He set the meeting at 2 a.m. tonight.
What's going on? Is the mirror fixed yet?
Bluebeard, this isn't the time.
Is the mirror fixed or isn't it? You called me to...
I called just to see if you knew where Crane could be, and that was it, okay? And I'm sorry I said anything more than that.
Well, you did, and I know. The cat's out of the bag. So, can we find the dull pervert or not?
Bluebeard, get the hell out of here. This is none of your business.
None of my business? Crane's the murderer. He escaped. It seems he spoiled your every attempt at locating him. And now it's none of my business?
Yeah.
We don't know if he's the murderer.
Oh, please.
You wanted
of course
to kill Tito D, man.
Look, this just isn't the time. He took a piece of the mirror, so we can't use it.
The only thing we know is that Crane's going to see a witch at 2 o'clock.
A.M. or P.M.?
P.M. Signal.
A.M.
Listen, Bluebeard, you're not a part of this.
I don't think you're in any position to turn away help.
Why do you even care about this?
Why? I'm invested in this enterprise we call Fable Town.
Oh, God.
Literally invested, since it's mostly my money that keeps the whole thing running. And tonight I hear that Crane has been killing fables, and there's no system in place to catch him?
Look,
no.
We know that Crane is going to see a witch, and it's to acquire a magic ring.
What's the ring?
We don't know what it does or who it's assigned to since Crane tore its page out of the book.
This farce was your ridiculous idea for a plan. I mean, who put you in charge in the first place?
Fixing the mirror was the most logical
thing.
You're
a secretary. He's the sheriff. And none of you were chosen to run this office. Who elected you to make these decisions?
Nobody, but that
who
doesn't...
Who elected her to spend my money?
Well, I've been doing that unofficially for years now.
Unofficially is not officially.
I'm heading up the investigation, okay, Bluebeard? That makes this a moot point.
And somebody needs to run the business office while he does so.
Well then, excuse me for having the Commonwealth in mind.
All right, let's just look on the bright side. We know Crane is going to see the witch that's been supplying him black market glamours.
Thanks to me.
And that he'll be there at 2. So that gives us a few hours to find out who it is and where they live and get them all at once.
And a few shorter hours the more you babble about it.
We haven't been the ones babbling.
2 a.m. Piece of cake.
Since Lily used the glamours, she'd have known who the witch was. And I don't think Holly's burned her things yet. It would probably have the address or a phone number or something.
And Bigby is free to go there if he likes. But I think the question you should be asking is just what do the two Tweedles know about this?
It doesn't matter what they know. After tonight, they'd never go to their office.
They're not smart enough to try and go anywhere else.
The Trip Trap is the better option to track the witch down. That has to be our focus.
Look, chances are I'll have to swing by both anyways.
No, chances are you won't have time.
I don't really care what you two do. I'm going to his apartment.
What? You can't just go up there.
And why the hell not?
We already looked for the key, remember? I don't know where it is.
Then I'll pick the blasted lock! I've wasted enough time waiting for the mirror to find him. I won't waste any more.
You just can't go up there alone, all right?
I've no interest in nicking his drapes, my dear, if that's what concerns you.
What concerns me is you traipsing through possible evidence.
Oh. Now it's evidence. Before you had no interest, and now it's a crime scene.
Bluebeard, you're not going anywhere.
Really now? And what? You gonna stand here and babysit me while the rest of your leads evaporate into mist?
We have to find the witch, Bluebeard, since that's where he's going.
Or the sniveling weasel chickened out. Never went anywhere. And is upstairs right now in his pitiful penthouse, crafting a fort out of couch cushions. Look, this is how a smart person would do it. So this is how we're going to do it. Wherever you go, I'll go to the other.
I don't like you going anywhere unsupervised. He's up to something. I don't know what it is, but we don't have the time to really worry about it now. Where are you gonna go, Bigby?
I gotta go to Crane's first. What am I doing? What's going on? Oh, well. Okay.
So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy and I don't need charity.
Alright, so we're going to Crane.
Crane's place is right here. I should check that out first.
Perfect. And I'll go to those two imbeciles' office.
Crane's penthouse number is 1903. Let me know what you find. I hope you know what you're doing.
Oh, what big eyes you have. Who's going inside?
Crane?
Crane's apartment. Damn, even 5 minutes? He said it was upstairs or something like that, right?
Damn it. Must have missed him. There's gotta be something about his witch here.
Alright, so this is part of the book right here. Just looking at that. It's like, what the point of that? Okay. I guess we can listen to that.
And as much as I like making house calls, I have better ways to use my time. So, if you can go ahead and pay him by Friday, that would be great.
Crooked man.
All right?
This is
everybody
all I can get.
Upright.
I'm afraid Snow will start to notice. I'll have the rest for you
now. Next
week. Ichabod Crane. What's going on here?
Yeah, I'm taking that shit. Get out of here with that.
My dearest Snow, I know you must be aware of my feelings towards you. I'm watching you work. If I'm unable to control myself, it's because I love you. Might be useful.
Hey, stay where you are!
Jack? Wow, it is just unbelievable running into you here. I mean, of all the places. This weather, right? A little damp, I guess. But, you know, some people like that sort of thing.
Explain yourself. Now!
Okay. I know what it looks like, but before you go jump into conclusions, Crane pays me to water his plants when he's gone. It's a stipend, but you know I need the work. I wouldn't do it for free, right? You know me. So, anyways, now that I'm done...
I don't see any plants. Hey!
Okay! You got me. Damn, just take it easy. Don't make a big deal out of this.
I don't like being lied to.
Okay. I heard Crane was leaving town. I figured he owed us little people a parting gift. Or just me a parting gift.
You heard?
I have my sources, okay? You see how he lives. He doesn't need any of this shit.
Do you know where Crane is? Have you heard anything else about him?
No. Should I have?
The fuck? ass.
What else do you want me to say? I got bills to pay. Not like Crane's gonna use any of this stuff.
Did somebody send you and tell the truth?
No, it's just me. Just take it easy. You know, this tortured, lonely pig-eater bit's gonna get old eventually. Don't you get tired of it? I mean, what are you even doing here? Are you just wandering around Crane's apartment?
I'm investigating.
Sure. Well, looks like you've got it covered. Anyway,
Dolph Ziggler,
it was really nice
ass.
Catching up with you. I mean that. Bigby, I believe you're, blocking the doorway there. If I could just,
squeeze
through.
Just going through the window.
You know, on second thought, it's actually funny I ran into you like this. I think I can help you out.
What do you mean?
You're looking for Crane, right? Well, I don't know where he is, but what if I told you I know who might know where he is? Word on the street says he's got a witch in the city. I can tell you who she is, if you're interested. Information comes at a price, though, but I'm sure you already knew that.
How convenient.
Convenient for you, Sheriff. I got the info you need. This is an easy win. Let's make ourselves a deal. I tell you about Crane's witch, and you forget you saw me here. One hand washes the other sort of thing. Wipe the whole incident under the rug. Come on, what do you say?
Fine. You got a deal.
Perfect.
Now tell me where I can find this witch.
Strong grip. Her name is Auntie Greenleaf. Crane's been trying to keep it under wraps for years. If you're looking for Crane, she might know how to find him.
I hope you're not lying to me, Jack.
Scout's on her, Sheriff.
Scout's on.
The thing is, I don't know where you'd find her, exactly.
You gotta be fucking kidding me.
But even a name is a good start, right? I mean, that's more than what you came in with.
Right.
I'll keep my eyes open for you. If I find anything else you might be interested in, I'll be sure to let you know. I think this arrangement can be beneficial to both of us down the line. It was just lovely running into you, Bigby.
Hang on a second.
Oh, come on.
Aw.
The white deer.
Do you always talk to yourself like that? The witch uses the white deer on everything. It's her symbol or trademark, I guess. Figured I could sell these at the Lucky Pawn.
The Lucky Pawn?
It's one of the Crooked Man's places. I work there sometimes. When I need some stability. It's a pawn shop. Get it?
Yeah, yeah. You find any more of these?
No.
Something crawl on my face.
Give them to me.
What?
You know what. Hand them over. That it?
Bigby? Are you still here?
Just keep your mouth shut, all right?
You're the boss.
I should have said,
who are you talking to? What's he doing here?
Evening, Miss White.
Good evening. What's going on?
That's not important right now. But he did have some information about Crane's witch.
Oh, what did you find out?
Her name is Greenleaf.
Auntie Greenleaf.
But he doesn't know where we can find her.
Great. Crane's meeting her at 2 a.m.
And Snow, I found a note with some money attached. Crane has been embezzling from Fable Town.
Of course, because why half-ass being a complete sleazeball? Do you think this is tied to the murders? I mean, I guess it doesn't matter yet.
I think it's connected. Maybe the girls found out about it? I don't know.
Maybe. Crane's meeting Greenleaf at 2 a.m. And we have no idea where she is. We're going to cut it close as it is.
I don't know, but I'll think of something.
Mm-hmm. I
You should try Holly's. She still has all of Lily's things.
If she hasn't burned it already.
There's still Tweedledee's place. We know they're involved. And we know that's where Bluebeard went. Where do you want
to
go? We don't have much time.
So I'll go to Tweedledee then.
I'll go pay the Tweedle brothers a visit. I'm sure they know something.
Okay. I'll give Buffkin the name and hope he finds something in the records.
Let me know what he comes up with.
I'll be in touch. I hope you'll do the same.
We'll catch him, Snow.
Hang on, Jack. I want to talk to you.
Oh, hi, Bluebeard. Oh, no, I'm sorry, big guy. You can't come in. Yeah, because the thing is, and I don't know if you'd heard, but I'm a third-degree black belt and, whatever. So I wouldn't take any chances, hombre. Last guy who messed with me got his marbles kicked right through his abdomen, all right?
Excuse me.
Oh. Hi, Sheriff.
Flycatcher.
What brings you here?
Who were you talking to just now? Yourself.
Bluebeard was here. He was looking for something. I don't know what. He said it was an official investigation. But how was I supposed to know if he was telling the truth? When I wouldn't let him in...
Shit.
Found what he was looking for, I guess. It's just super annoying. I just finished cleaning.
You know where he went?
No. I don't know what he wanted. I didn't see what he did after... I'm really sorry, Big B. Was he telling the truth? He said you sent him, but I don't know, I just thought he was lying. I'm not supposed to just let people in here. But then he got mad, saying, just terrible things.
Don't worry about it, Flycatcher.
Oh, I'm gonna get fired. Crane already let me go from the Woodlands.
Is that why you're here?
He said I just got in the way, told me to get lost. The twins offered me a job here working the night shift, so I'd have something. What do I do now? It's nice, you know, quiet. I come in and clean up.
You should talk to Snow. Maybe there's something she can do for you.
Really? That would be... thank you.
Look, I'm running out of time.
Got some other shit to do.
Ah, shit.
Is everything okay?
I gotta go.
What? Where?
I'm headed to the Trip Trap. Just call Snow and tell her what's happened, okay? Can you do that for me?
Okay, I guess. And I'll ask her about that job, all right?
Sure. Take care of yourself, Fly.
You too, Sheriff Bigby.
Trip Bar.
We're closed.
Guys, it's me, Bigby.
Hey, this is
look,
nice.
Woody, it's the sheriff. Well, come on in, buddy.
Brent. This is nice.
What? He's a traveler. A weary traveler in search of some hospitality, right?
Yeah, sure. Thanks.
I want a drink. Anybody else want a drink?
Brent, Swinehart said you shouldn't mix
you
it.
You think I give a fuck what that fucking guy says?
Wow.
What you say?
Brent, really, you shouldn't drink right now. Swinehart told me that Holly was here. I need to talk to her.
Holly's asleep in back, but you won't be able to wake her.
Really? The doc gave him both barmesidal ambrosia for the pain.
Look, the deal is, if you resist going to sleep, like I am right now, it gives you a very, very, very nice high.
and he said that he shouldn't mix it with alcohol.
Mad turn.
Yes, he did. He certainly did. But let me tell you something. I haven't felt this good in a long time, fat boy.
There's no way to wake her up.
No. And anyways, the doctor gave me strict orders to let the fine woman sleep. She's had a very traumatic experience.
Oh yeah, with that damn shotgun on her face.
That funeral back there? That was a shitty fucking send-off for a pretty okay lady.
Yeah.
You weren't fucking there. I'm talking to Bigby now, okay?
Damn. Dig.
Can't say you being there helped things much.
Gren, don't start nothing.
Who's starting anything?
You think I shot up the place? It wasn't my fault.
They got away, though, didn't they? Whatever. It's all right. I'm too out of it to get into it. I want to clear the air. We're all in this dung heap of a fucking shit town together. We're all gonna have a toast. All of us.
Fellas, I'm here for one thing. To look through Lily's belongings and get out of here. Now,
I know. And I want to help you, okay? And I will. But first, indulge me. It'll take 2 seconds. As a show of good faith. And after, we'll all hunt and peck for Lily's shit or whatever.
Grand Bigby didn't come here to get loaded with you.
I don't want to get loaded with him.
I'm running out of time, Gren.
God damn.
Gren, the doc said you needed a rest.
How many times you fucking gonna warn me about it, huh? You're not my fucking mother, so just get off my back!
I said I was sorry, all right? I can't do anything about it, it's done!
Leo. I don't care.
What more do you want? What else can I fucking say here?
Cut this shit out now. I don't care what it's about.
Oh, I forgot. You haven't heard the news. This walking lard cake was paying Holly's sister to let him fuck her behind all of our backs. And Holly had to find out going through all of her sister's shit. What fun that must have been. Trick after trick of this fat ass and Lily.
I didn't plan for that, all right? And our thing, whatever it was, it wasn't a big deal. It wasn't. I never fucked her when she was snowing. I didn't know nothing about that.
No, but you knew Holly would flip out. And you knew for a damn good fucking reason.
You know what? Fuck this. I don't need this shit.
Oh yeah, that's it. Now you're teary-eyed. You were always such a lowlife. I don't know why I never realized it till now. What do you think about this fucking loser, Sheriff?
He can think whatever he wants.
Wait. I've got some questions for you.
What possible questions could you have for this piece of shit? Everything's a problem when I want to talk, but when the woodsman's about to leave, it's, oh wait, I have questions.
What do you want?
When Tweedledee came in here 2 nights ago, why'd you run?
I was scared, okay? I didn't want to go down for something I didn't do. I never would have hurt that girl, Bigby.
All right.
Gren. I don't know where Lily's shit is. Check Holly's room, I don't know. But I wouldn't wake her if I were you. Sleepwalkers and trolls. I think that's the rule. Maybe, ogres, too.
Thanks for the...
Actually, Bigby, if you'll excuse me, it seems that I'm gonna pass out. What a day. Am I right, Sheriff? What a fucking day.
Won't remember us.
Thank you.
there's anything here. No. I just caught. Again.
Excuse me, but I'm not in the mood for entertaining. But what the fuck? I know you're not gonna leave. You do what you want. You always do what you want.
Yeah. That's when you're police. You just arrest people for no reason.
Do you even give a shit about us? The strays. The ones that aren't in that fancy high rise. Those of us that gotta work for a living.
You may not believe this, but yeah, I care about everyone who came over.
I don't know about that, Sheriff. You're friends with your friends, and we ain't friends. Why'd you even come here? There's nothing here to investigate. I can't be any use to you.
I'm tracking a lead.
To Crane?
Yeah.
That's the ones you gave, right? No, it's just the book.
Be honest, Sheriff. Why are you going after him? Crane. You could have quit a long time ago, but you're still going. Why? Did they give you this job for a reason? Or was this the only thing the business office would let you do?
Most likely.
I'm doing this for faith.
Oh, at least you're honest. You just remember, whatever bullshit excuse you tell yourself, I'm counting on you. So don't have any more fuck-ups.
You're getting your glamour on this day, and one of these has to be the witch. Auntie Greenleaf. Gotcha.
Hello, this is Snow White calling. I'm looking for Bigby. Is anyone there? Bigby, if you're there, pick up, okay?
Snow?
Oh, thank God. Tell me you found something.
I got it, Snow. Her address was here with Lily's things. It's on, White Plains Avenue, 1284. It's an apartment complex.
Great. Let's get going. Crane's meeting her in a few minutes.
All right, let's go. I don't want to miss him.
I'll meet you there.
All right, I'll see you there.
Huff and puff. Is that cigarettes?
Bigby! I just got here.
Yeah, me too. It's number 23. I haven't seen it yet.
We're late.
Yeah, I know. This is it.
All right. How do you want to do this?
Knock on the door. Actually, yeah, here first.
Hear anything?
If anyone's in there, they're being awfully quiet.
Oh, see? They just opened the door.
Hello?
Hi.
You woke me up.
Sorry about that.
Is something wrong?
Sorry about that, Munchkin.
Who are you?
Rachel, who are you? Just so we're not strangers.
Well, I'm the sheriff, and this is my partner.
Boss.
Pleased to meet you. How do you do? Is there anything you need?
Is Auntie Greenleaf at home? Does she live here?
You mean my mom?
She ever, you know, make the nightstand levitate, turn frogs into cats, that kind of thing?
Is she a witch, dear?
No, I would never call my mommy that. She treats me all right. Is there something you want? I don't think I can really help you.
Snow, can you just do something here? I never have any idea what to say to these people.
Yeah. You mean children?
Yeah.
Do you mind if my friend here takes a look around? I promise we'll be quick so you can hurry back to bed.
I've been here all night. Nobody's been here.
Why you be by yourself then?
Okay, boss. I'm gonna trust your friend not to break anything. Don't get me in trouble.
Look for anything unusual.
Yeah, like Crane. He could still be here.
Just look at this tree.
What is this?
Mommy uses that to carve her trinkets. It's from the old world.
Trinkets? Like glamours?
Not here.
There's no one here but me.
Damn, bitch. Calm down.
No one's been over all night, so...
He's just going to check. It'll only take a moment.
There's nothing that looks like Crane was here either.
Nothing?
See?
Oh, there it is.
A butcher.
What's that?
A package having to do with someone called the Butcher. It's empty. God damn it.
I shouldn't say that.
Nothing.
I keep getting whiffs of that aftershave of his.
I do too.
Can I go to bed now, please?
No.
Is that a glamour tube?
Mommy really doesn't let anyone play with that. Trust me, I've tried. Oh, no, 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 no. Please, 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 just put that back exactly where you found it. No one is allowed to play with
that. It's all right, honey. Bigby's not going to break it.
You don't understand. She will freak out if she discovers I've let people in here and let them touch her stuff, okay? She checks all the time to see if things move.
I'm not gonna break it. I just wanna open it.
No! Put it down! Please, don't! This isn't what you think! You gotta believe me! That guy isn't here, I promise!
It's gonna be okay, Rachel.
Please, I'm begging you. I don't wanna get in trouble.
Uh-oh.
Auntie Greenleaf.
Oh?
It hurts when you do it that fast.
You think we have time to waste on this shit? You think this is some kind of game?
No.
Yeah, what the fuck?
I don't. But congratulations on winning.
Why you gotta be like
that? If that matters to you.
All right, start explaining.
None of this pathetic witchcraft crap is gonna prevent me from prying what I need from your gullet. Now tell me where Crane is.
I ain't a fortune teller, Wolf. I have no heavenly idea where he went to.
You have to know something.
Unless you want a recipe for owl stew.
You're an accomplice to murder. Do you realize that?
You might want to check your facts on that. It doesn't matter. I can't help you. I have no interest in being turned into a skink and crushed under boot heels. There's powers at work here beyond your pathetic authority.
Whatever it is, Greenleaf, whatever it is that's keeping you from saying something...
I don't give a shit about your problems, Greenleaf. Just talk, now.
You have no idea what's going on, do you?
No.
Okay, you know what I think? I think we've been more than patient with you. This witch has been selling illegal glamours that continue to undermine everything we've built. She's harboring a fugitive that took advantage of it, and now she's resisting every attempt to make things right. I frankly don't give a crap. If she's afraid for her life, we can at least make sure she never hurts us again. We're destroying the tree.
No! How dare you come in here and threaten to take from me the one thing that... That tree is ancient. It's part of the family, and it's the only thing paying for this shithole apartment. And the Fables, who can't afford the glamours from you, come to me for help. Without them, where do you think they could go?
Don't give me that. You're making money off of other people's misery. Two Fables are dead because of this crap. It's too dangerous leaving this stuff with her.
You think I like being the old woman in these stories? The men are heroes, the ladies are whores, and the old hags like me get to watch everyone they love die.
We have very different ways of handling our fate.
Very different means to handle it, too.
And I don't use it as an excuse to wreck people's lives.
I'm sorry, Sheriff, but please.
Greenleaf Snow's right. The tree has to go.
No! Look, I'll tell you. Crane was here. He was here, and he left. He went to the pudding and pie to try to use my ring on the girls over there to get information.
What does the ring do?
He thinks it's the ring of dispel. You know, that will pierce the protection around the girl's speech. He says pulling the truth out of them will prove his innocence. It won't, though. Damn thing lost its power decades ago. Just please, you can catch him if you leave, okay? Just leave, and don't burn my tree.
I'm burning it.
I'm begging you. I'm begging you.
Orders are orders.
That's it, we done. That gotta be with the police. That's cool, it was all blue.
Do you know that?
Oh well. Not my problem.
I told you everything, and then you extinguished the only measure I have in this horrid world.
Yeah.
What monsters are you?
Pretty sure you got some veins in the background and you can use those. I mean, I don't know what's the problem.
I have nothing! Nothing! You took everything from me! I have nothing!
Don't worry, girl. That's how I feel. That's exactly how I feel. Severe case of love. What the fuck? I can't read that.
Crane's car.
Oh, he's here.
No, it's nothing you need to concern yourself with. I don't think so, at least.
Shit.
Hold on. Sheriff, is there something more I can help you with? Decided you want a taste of the wares? Oh, I see. Come to audition, you bitch.
No.
Get out of the way.
I'm in your way, love.
Tell me what you know, now!
Hey, you can't just go in there. We have a problem.
Tell me who did it. Just tell me who did it. I know you know.
Mr. Crane, please. She can't help.
I know you know what the plan is. I won't be held accountable for this.
I can't. I'm sorry.
Crane, get away from her.
I didn't do anything. I promise you, I didn't do anything. These girls, the girls, they'll back me up. I just stupid ring working, that's all. They can't talk because of that spell, but once this ring gets through, I'll know what's going on and this whole thing will be over. That's all, please. I'm innocent, completely, completely innocent.
The ring won't work. Greenleaf sold you out.
What? No, this will work. I assure you, it must. I went to...
Okay, Green Lantern, come on, bro.
Come on, please. Tell me who killed her.
My lips are sealed.
Oh. Oh, well.
How many years?
What?
How many years has this been going on?
Too many.
Ugh.
But I didn't kill those women, Bigby. Please, I had nothing to do with that.
I just...
Oh, God.
We found the photos of you and Lily.
I know.
I just love you, Snow. I love you, and
I'm sorry I'm not Prince Charming, okay? I'm sorry I didn't cheat on you and run away to Europe.
You don't love me, Crane. I know what this is. I've seen it before. It is not love.
Hmm. I guess. Hmm.
Bigby? I don't think he did it.
What?
Look at him. Do you really think this man murdered these women? He wouldn't be brave enough. Not to put his stamp on the world like that.
How would you know?
Chasing this guy. Just, why now?
Because, look at him. You said you found evidence of him defrauding Fabletown. Of using our money for his own ambitions. That's one thing. But don't you have doubts he's a murderer? We've both known him for so long.
I can't believe I'm hearing this. Did you see how he was acting when you showed up?
No, Snow. I have no doubt. He's the killer.
But why? Really? Think about it.
He glamored a prostitute to look like you. He played out his sick fucking fantasies over and over.
Exactly.
We can't condemn people to death for just being gross.
Snow,
and
I
think
you could have killed
her
after.
No evidence that says anything except he was in the same room at some point in time. He embezzled millions from Fabletown, Bigby. That's what I have to care about. And that's enough.
I was gonna pay all of that back.
It's still fucking disgusting.
Look, I know how badly you want this to be over with. I want it to be over with too. And I have more reason than anyone here to hate him. And I do, and I will, forever. But I want him brought in for what he did to this town, and not killed by you for personal preference. Ichabod Crane, you are under arrest for the misappropriation of Fabletown funds. You have the right to counsel, the right to depose witnesses.
Get the fuck up.
Damn.
Now.
All right, dude.
I guess
why
we
you mad?
Who's in charge, Sheriff?
It's not about who's in charge. It's about doing your job.
Oh, is it? You think you have what it takes to run that office? You think I didn't make sacrifices? I made sacrifices. And you won't be in that chair 1 minute before you have to give up something you care about just so the wheels don't fall off the goddamn wagon.
I did the best I could with what I had.
Better save your energy, huh? You're going away for a long time.
Ooh, that music though.
Stupid girls and their preposterous schemes.
What are you saying?
Oh, shit.
Shit.
I'm gonna walk the other way. Oh.
Look, it's recently come under our attention that you're, how shall I put this, attempting to claim what is the personal property of the Crooked Man. He's about yay high, 120 odd pounds, pissed his sheets until he was 14. Sound familiar?
I haven't told him anything.
Not now, not now. Shh. The grown-ups are talking.
Who are you?
No, 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 no. That's not how this works. How this works is you are going to walk Crane over here, like a good doggy.
No.
It wasn't my fault.
Shut up. You're interfering with official Fabletown business. Step aside.
Tweedledee, what's the, you know, that thing the Mundys call me?
What?
My nickname. You know what I'm talking about.
Bloody Mary,
that's it. Thank you. And do you know why they call me that? Because some of them, they think it's funny to have their little sleepovers and go into their little bathrooms and say my name 5 times in the mirror. They find it less funny when I actually show up and feed their lungs to the family dog. And I do that for a hobby. Like golf, to relax.
You can fuck off if you think you're getting him.
Yeah.
I told you he'd never just give him up.
Fuck it.
Shit. Peace, Bigby.
Bigby?
Oh. Oh, shit. If I go to jail, I go to jail. It's all right. You try to kill me, so. Now she try to kill. I'm about to kill her, too. Fuck that.
Oh God, Bigby!
It was a good show. But, you know, it just didn't know when to end.
She got the Magnum. Oh shit.
You know, you didn't think silver bullets would work on anything but a pure werewolf. But as it turns out,
oh, God damn it. It's one of those X's.
Right, Wolfie? I mean, hey, look, I know it sounds ridiculous, but really, guys. Can you argue with these results? Because I know I can't.
No.
Wait! Stop!
Take Crane.
Just take him, yep. Okay? Take Crane.
Yep, I already know.
Just stop, please.
Yeah, I don't know.
Snow, don't do this.
No, don't do it. I got you. What the hell's that?
It's your lucky day, kid. Crooked Man says it's okay with him. Hello, Ichabod. Got a stomach ache? Oh, and just between us girls, Crane ain't no killer. I mean, look at his face. Couldn't stick a pig if his life depended. Nope, not like your boyfriend. Well, this is gonna be a beautiful relationship we have with you guys.
Broke his arm.
Really, I mean it. I'm jazzed about it. Out with the old, in with the new. Long live the queen.
God damn.
I'm sure we'll be in touch.
Yeah.
See you around.
All right, see you later. Zoe Sarketa, so no. The Enchanted Land of New York City.